Kalangala District occupies space which supports standing of aircrafts while landing and taking off. This makes it sufficient for emergency landing of an aircraft in case of engine failure or any other technical fault. During a training session at Wamala Resort Hotel in Kalangala, the discussions were centered on how to handle emergencies and rescues when it comes to both air and water transport.
This is a process that, involves assisting people in distress in attempting to save personnel and property when there is distress on any aircraft that would be, in flight. And so while indeed we can do this job as air traffic controllers, we cannot accomplish the objective alone. It is necessary that the local people, in the course of their existence, also know that they have a responsibility.
We normally do sensitizations of this nature because we assume that an aircraft, can easily land on water. And when it lands on water, it simply means the Maritime Administration is going to take effect that same incidence. And then also, we are guided by the ICAO, the International Civil Aviation Organization, and IMO, the International Maritime Organization.
Leaders also hinted at government plans to set up helipads, areas designated for landing and takeoff of helicopters.
Incidentally, Kalangala is gifted. And we believe that one day, we're going to have an airstream on one of the islands. Kalangala basically is a tourism attraction. Our government hasn't only tapped into it deeply.
Leaders welcome the training, saying this will help educate islanders with emergency and rescue skills.
We have been having some challenges here and there with these aircraft. Sometimes, as you know, in Kalangala, we don't have a helipad or airfield, but they usually come and land around. So we just request that if the aviation can construct an airstrip or an airfield in Kalangala, it would be safe, because sometimes they come and use our local playgrounds at school, and sometimes we may not have information or alert.
It's really grateful that we are hosting them today. And we are having high hopes that soon we are establishing a new transport ways, which is going to favor the islanders.
These trainings will be consistently held in all the districts across the country with an aim of equipping citizens with enough rescue techniques when it comes to any form of emergencies. Kalangala has recorded several boat tragedies, including in August when dozens perished when the boat they were traveling in capsized. In July, 6 people died in an accident involving 2 boats, and in 2021, over 50 people drowned. Report compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.